Greetings, colleagues. For those who don't know me, I'm Kabelo Monama, the concept dietitian in Witbank Hospital. This dietitian was trained at Sefako Magatho Health Sciences University, abbreviated SMU. So today, as we're entering the National Nutrition Week, I'll be presenting or focusing on why should one lead a healthy lifestyle. Because remember, we're working in a health sector, so we should be a motivation to our clients or rather our patients. So the reason why we should lead a healthy lifestyle is because we want to make sure that we try to prevent or manage the existing chronic conditions, of which we know we've got four main types of that. And these conditions, they are the main causes of death around the world. And then we've got cardiovascular diseases, of which it can be illustrated by all these three posters. And one might ask, why am I saying this falls under cardiovascular diseases? Remember, cardiovascular diseases are a group of conditions of which they include things like your high blood pressure, strokes, your heart attacks. That's why I'm including all these things, even the cholesterol. If ever maybe you've got increased levels of cholesterol in the body, that puts you at high risk of these cardiovascular conditions. And the last one of these four main types is the diabetes mellitus. And then with all these conditions, someone might ask still, why should I be concerned with my health in relation to all these conditions? What would happen to me if ever I don't keep up my health? Because I don't have these conditions, so they don't affect me. But you should know, you should bear in mind that all these conditions, they affect us all. But the problem is not only the deaths that arise from these conditions. The other things that hurt us as health professionals is that these conditions, we're wasting a lot of money, a lot of resources around them because of the way they complicate. For people who have them already, we're paying a lot. And then remember, government doesn't just have money out of the blue. The money that they have, they generate it from what? From the tax. And the tax that we pay for each and every day, the companies are paying a lot of tax. We are paying a lot of tax. So we should make sure that we at least control these conditions if ever we have them or manage them. Or if we don't have them, let's please try to prevent them. Because we know the complications around these conditions, there are a lot. Like for example, let's say for example you have diabetes mellitus and then it's poorly controlled. And that puts you at a very high risk of getting things like your leg being amputated. And then someone might ask, how is that possible? Let's say for example you're not controlling your blood sugar properly. Remember, this blood sugar is the one that we need to go to different body parts so as to make sure that it gives these body parts enough energy to maintain daily activities. So if ever these body parts, they don't get this energy, it means that even the body soldiers or the immune cells amongst these body parts, they won't get energy. Then they won't be able to fight off infections. So you'd be at risk of different infections. And then again, let's say for example you get injured on your leg, then it means the wound that would arise from the leg, it will be difficult for it to heal off because of what? You've got too much sugar in the blood. That makes the microorganisms to multiply or bacteria to multiply rapidly, and then again it will be difficult for that wound to heal, then the leg rots. So if ever it does that, then there won't be any medication that will be provided to you to reverse that process. The only thing that will be left is for doctors to do it, to amputate the leg. There were studies that were done before. The studies are still continuing now. So, and then it has been found in some studies, like in 2002, the study that was done by World Health Organization, they found out that these conditions were amongst the largest causes of death in the world. And then to be more specific, it was found that all these conditions, they contributed about 29 million deaths around the world, of which that's a huge number. It means that we're losing a lot of people from these conditions. Okay, so in conclusion, the main reason why you should live a healthy lifestyle is because, remember, all these conditions can be prevented. So we want you to be able to prevent these conditions. Or rather, if ever you have them, you should make sure that at least you try to manage them as good as possible. So that will help us in a lot of things, economics, our budget, and everything like that. So the last thing that I would say to you, remember, you are what you eat. Thank you.